Electron configuration refers to the arrangement of the electrons in an atom into orbitals. To determine the electron configuration of an atom with multiple electrons, we follow something called the Aufbau Principle. Aufbau is a German word that means to build up, and that's what you do in this process. You build up the electron configuration from the bottom up in this diagram of orbitals. Electrons seek the lowest energy state, starting with the 1s orbital. We use arrows to represent electrons, and the direction they're pointing shows the direction of their spin. According to the Pauli Exclusion Principle, each orbital holds a maximum of 2 electrons with opposite spins. So there's a maximum of 2 electrons in the 1s orbital. If the atom has more than 2 electrons, they start filling in the subsequent higher energy orbitals. Let's see some examples. Hydrogen has 1 electron, so it goes into the 1s orbital. We write the electron configuration as 1s1. The first number shows the energy level, and the exponent on s shows the number of electrons in the s orbital. Helium has 2 electrons, so those 2 electrons both go in the 1s orbital, with opposite spins. The electron configuration is written as 1s2. Lithium has 3 electrons, so we know it will start to fill a higher orbital, since the 1s orbital can only hold 2 electrons. We write this as 1s2, 2s1. Again, remember that the large numbers represent the energy levels of the orbitals, and the superscripts represent the number of electrons in that orbital. Beryllium has 4 electrons. We fill the diagram from the bottom up. The electron configuration is 1s2, 2s2. Next comes boron with 5 electrons. We're now starting to fill in the 2p subshell. P subshells have 3 orbitals, px, py, and pz, which can each hold 2 electrons, for a total of 6 electrons. We put the first electron in 2px. The electron configuration of boron is written as 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. Carbon has 6 electrons. Where does that second electron go in the p orbitals? According to Hund's rule, every orbital in a subshell gets 1 electron before any orbitals get 2 electrons, and each of the single electrons have parallel spin. So, we put the next electron in 2py, with an up arrow to show it has the same spin as the electron in the 2px orbital. After the second energy level, you really have to pay attention to the energy level diagram. For instance, notice that the 4s orbital has lower energy than the 3d orbital, so you should fill the 4s orbital first. But these two orbitals are so close in energy that for a few elements, electrons go into the 3d orbital first. For example, in chromium, the electron configuration ends in 3d5 4s1 instead of 3d4 4s2. Similarly, copper's electron configuration ends with 3d10 4s1 rather than 3d9 4s2. The rationale for these exceptions to the Aufbau principle is that half-filled or completely filled subshells are particularly stable arrangements of electrons. In another video, we will discuss some tips and tricks to make writing electron configurations go a little faster, including how to find electron configurations by referring to the periodic table.